students, how are you spending your holiday? I hope you are having fun in these days. So, today our lesson is 1B. The topic is basics of e-learning. Again, before beginning our lesson, we will make brief contents. The first task, we will see revision of previous lessons grammar. Then we will look through vocabulary again. Next thing, I will explain you new grammar, reported speech. And we will see some tasks on reported speech on page 142. And the next, last thing, you will have your home assignments. So let's begin. Grammar review. As you remember, we had compound nouns previous lesson. We had them noun plus noun, adjective plus noun, and verb plus noun. So we had some examples for noun plus noun. The first is car park, second is Iceland, shopkeeper, and website. For adjective plus noun, we have examples like as blackberry, grandstand, greenhouse, and small talk. And the last one is verb plus noun, breakwater, fall guy, go-kart, and runway. So, many compound nouns are written, as I told you, with hyphens or with spaces or both together. We had examples for them. The first is where we use both words together. They are bathroom, sheepdog, and windscreen. For using with hyphens, we had examples the same like as check-in, firefighter, son-in-law. And the last one without hyphens, with spaces, we had examples like as bottle opener, New Year's Day, and prime minister. So now then we will have vocabulary revision. So as you see, the first picture is microphones. And the second picture is USB cable. The third one is monitor, and the fourth one is speaker. So next is, the first picture is keyboard, second picture is CD disc, the third one is tablet, and the fourth one is laptop. I hope you have reviewed with them. Now I will explain you new grammar. Our new grammar topic is reported speech. We use reported speech to tell somebody's speech, paraphrasing to it with our own words. So let's begin. When we use reported speech, we either report statements, questions, requests, comments, and other types. So let's see first statements. When we transform in statements, we try to pay attention to pronouns, tenses, and place and time expressions. That means when we pay attention to pronouns in reported speech, we have often to change the pronouns depending on who says what. For example, she says, my dad likes roast chicken. Here, as you see, we said, she says, my dad likes roast chicken. When we change them into reported speech or we report them, we say, she says that. In spite of using my, we say her. Her dad likes roast chicken. While changing tenses or while paying attention to the tenses, we should pay attention. There is no break shifts of tense in reported speech. If the sentence starts in the past, there is often break shifts of tenses in reported speech. For example, he says, I write poems. Here, he says, I write poems. Pay attention. The verb is written without S, but here the word he says begins in present tense. That is why we just change he says that. The pronouns I will change he, and then the verb write we change into writes. It comes out he says that he writes poems. Next, when we use he said in past form, we should pay attention to the verb, which we should change them it into past one. It comes out, he said, I write poems, and then comes, he said that he wrote poems. Last, the third thing where statements we should pay attention is place and time expression. Place, demonstratives, and time expressions change if the text of the reported statement is different from that of the direct speech. So, here we have tenses. So, from direct speech, we will change them into indirect speech. Present simple. The first is present simple. If we say, I like ice cream, and we use the first part of the sentence in past form, we say, she said she liked ice cream. Here we change it, both pronouns and the tense. Next, present continuous. We are saying, I'm living in Tashkent. The progress is happening now. And if we change that into past one, he said he was living in Tashkent. Both pronoun and the verb, we change it. Third one, past simple. I bought a car. If the sentence is used in a past, and then while we are changing from past simple, we make the tense into past perfect tense. It comes like this. I bought a car. While changing, he said he had bought a car, or she said she bought a car. Both we can use even past perfect tense or past simple tense. Fourth one, past continuous. If we are making sentence in a past form, and then I was walking along the street, this sentence we should change into past perfect continuous tense. It sounds like this. She said she had been walking along the street. Next is present perfect. If we make sentences in present perfect tense, and then it is changed into past perfect tense. I haven't seen Julie. And if we change it into reported speech, she said she hadn't seen Julie comes. And the last one is past perfect. If we make sentences in past perfect, like I had taken English lessons before, and then we can leave it as it was made. She said she had taken English lessons before. With future words or with modal verbs. With will, if we make sentence, I'll see you later, and then if we change them into past one, then we will change the word will into would. I will see you later, and then if we make it in reported speech, she said she would see me later. Here we change it both will and we use in spite of the word you, me. Next, would. Here if we use the would, we leave it as it is. I would help, but if we make it into indirect speech, we can say he said he would help it, but. While using modal verb, we can say I can speak English, but when we change it into indirect speech in past form, we say he said he could speak English. Next, if we use could, we use it as it is. I could swim when I was 4. She's emphasizing she used to do something when she was 4. And then if we make it into indirect speech, we can say, she said she could swim when she was 4. We didn't change anything except the word she. Here we change it only pronoun. And then we can use shall, I shall come later. In spite of I shall come later using indirect speech, we can make sentences. She said she would come later. Why didn't we say should? We usually use the word should in suggestions. That is why in spite of should, we use would. Next, should. I should call my mother. Here the word should is used as a suggestion. That is why we don't change it into something, just we leave it as it is. Here it comes like this. She said she could call her mother. Here, time expressions place demonstratives. While we are changing time expressions, we should pay attention to the following words. The word today is changed into that day. The word now is changed into then. Yesterday is into the day before, the days ago is changed into days before, last week is changed into the week before, next year is to the following year, tomorrow is next or the following. About place, the word here is changed into there. Demonstratives, that means demonstrative pronouns. The word this is changed into that, and this is changed into those. Reporting questions. When we are reporting questions, we should pay attention to the pronouns again, tenses, place and time expressions, and some transforming question words. The first, I have already explained that we should pay to pronouns. If the word is used with I, we should change them into she or he. If the word is used, if the tense is used, here we should pay attention to the present or past meaning of these sentences. And place and time, again, I have explained already. That is why here I have to clear out that transforming the questions, you know, into indirect questions and the use the question words. Here we should pay attention to general questions and special questions. Let's see. If we are using the questions with what, why, where, how, here we have example, why don't you speak English? This word, if we change into indirect speech, we use he asked me. We leave the same word why, but we change the person and the sentence into statement in spite of interrogative sentences. Here it comes like this. He asked me why I didn't speak English. Next, if we use general question or kind of without, kind of questions without what words, just yes or no, here we say, did you speak English? If we change it into indirect one, we say, he asked me, in spite of using question words, we say if or whether, and then we continue it in statement. I speak English. It comes like this. He asked me whether if I could speak English. So, reporting requests and comments. In reporting requests and comments, we should pay attention to pronouns, place and time expressions, the same. Here we simply use to or not to, plus verb without infinitive. So, here we can see some requests. Nancy, do the exercise. If we change this sentence into indirect speech, we say, he told Nancy to do the exercise. Second, Nancy, give me your pen, please. If we change it into indirect speech, we can say, he asked Nancy to give him her pen. So, other transformations. Expression of advice with must, could, ought to, we usually report using the verbs advise or urge. That means, in spite of using must, should, ought to, just we use advice or the word urge. Next, the expression let's is usually reported using suggest. In this case, there are two possibilities for reported speech, gerund or statement with should. For example, if we say, let's go to cinema and we change it into indirect speech, we can say, he suggested going to the cinema, the word we said suggested, or he suggested that we should go to the cinema. And now, open your books on page 142, exercise number 2, and you have tasks for reported speech. Here, the first sentence I will try to explain you. The question is, why doesn't this computer work? The teacher asked us. If we change this sentence into reported speech, the first thing we will do is teacher asked us. This part of the sentence we use in the first position. Teacher asked us the reason why that computer didn't work. If you paid attention, we had changed some parts of the sentence. Even the sentence was in the present form. The part of teacher asked was in past form, that is why we use it didn't work. Next is, what are you copying and pasting from the net? My mother asked me. Here, we should pay attention to the word present or past form of the sentences. As my mother asked me, this part is in the past form, we change the question into the past form too. It comes like this, my mother asked me, what I was copying and pasting from the net. And the last one, the third thing is, did you install the antivirus I bought yesterday? My father asked. Here again, the sentence is left in past form. That is why we should change it into past form. But if you paid attention here, the sentence is in past form, the question part of the sentences. That is why. While making sentences, we should change this question form of sentence in the past perfect tense. Here it comes like this. My father asked, or my father wondered me if whether I installed the antivirus he had bought the day before yesterday. So we have already looked through three of the sentences. That is why I ask you to do the other parts of the sentences at home. Now, your home assignment. The first is to review vocabulary once more. The second is to review compound nouns once more. And the third one is to read and repeat the grammar reported speech and to do the task on page 142, exercise number 2. Thank you for your attention. Goodbye, students.